नमस्कार, हूँ आदर्श सु। वेलकम टू आदर्श एजुकेशन सोसाइटी।
दिस इज पार्ट 3 ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड 7 सब्जेक्ट साइंस चैप्टर 1 न्यूट्रिशन इन प्लांट्स। अप टू पार्ट 2 वी डिस्कस्ड अप टू दिस टॉपिक। नाउ आवर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज अदर मोड्स ऑफ न्यूट्रिशन इन प्लांट्स। There are some plants which do not have chlorophyll. They cannot synthesize food. How do they survive and from where do they derive nutrition? Because they do not contain chlorophyll. Like humans and animals, such plants depend on the food produced by other plants. They are used heterotrophic mode. Heterotrophic mode of nutrition. Like at figure 1.5, do you see a yellow wiry branched structure twining around the stem and branches of a tree? This is a plant called Cuscuta, that is amarbel. It does not have chlorophyll. It takes ready-made food from the plant on which it is climbing. The plant on which it climbs called the host. Since it deprives the host of valuable nutrients. Now here deprives, that is as it uses the nutrients of that plant, that tree, that is why it deprives, means it damages the host of valuable nutrients. Now let's see this figure in which you can see there is a tree on which some wire structures are there, that is amarbel. Yellow wire structure, can you see that? That is amarbel, and it does not contain chlorophyll, so it depends on the nutrients of this tree. Cuscuta is called the parasite. Now this tree is host and Cuscuta, that is amarbel, is called parasite or parasite. Are we and other animals also a kind of parasite? You should think about it and discuss with your teacher. Here, Paheli wants to know whether mosquito, bed bugs, lice and leeches that suck our blood are also parasites. Yeah, those are parasites. Have you seen or heard of plants that can eat animals? There are a few plants which can trap insects and digest them. Is it not amazing? Such plants may be green or of some other color. Look at the plant in figure 1.6. First of all, let's look this figure. This is a pitcher plant showing lid and pitcher. See, you can see there is a plant, and here at the end of this leaf, you can see pitcher like structure. This is a pitcher like structure, and this is a lid. Here you can see very well. This is like pitcher, that is jug of water jug. You can understand. And this is a lid. Okay, let's go further. The pitcher-like or jug-like structure is the modified part of leaf. The apex of the leaf forms a lid. Now, what is apex? Apex is top or highest part of leaf. Here you can see. See, there is a leaf, then after there is a pitcher, and this is the top or the highest part, or we can say the end of the leaf, and it becomes a lid. So apex is top or highest part of leaf. The apex of the leaf forms a lid, which can open and close the mouth of pitcher. Inside the pitcher, there are hair, which are directed downwards. When an insect lands in the pitcher, the lid closes and the trapped insect gets entangled into the hair. Now, there are many hair in the pitcher and are directed downwards. When insect lands in the pitcher, lid closes. So, now it cannot come out. And the other thing, what happens? And the trapped insect gets entangled. Entangled means difficult to escape. So, now it is not possible for the insect to come out of the pitcher. The lid closes and insect is trapped. The insect is digested by the digestive juices secreted in the pitcher and its nutrients are absorbed. Then what happens? The insect is digested by the digestive juices secreted in the pitcher and its nutrients are absorbed. Such insect-eating plants are called insectivorous plants. This is an insectivorous plant. It is possible that such plants do not get all the required nutrients from the soil in which they grow. Now, Bujo has one question. Bujo is confused. If the pitcher plant is green and carries out photosynthesis, then why does it feed on insects? The answer is here. Such plants do not get all the required nutrients from the soil in which they grow. That is why, to fulfill the requirement of all nutrients, what they will do? They will catch the insects and then after it absorbs the nutrients of the insects. And those plants are known as insectivorous plants. Now, in the next lecture, in the next part, we will discuss about the saprotrophs. Up to this part, we discussed, let's revise. First of all, we discussed about the nutrients, total 5 nutrients are there, and 2 other essential parts of food are dietary fiber and water. That what we discussed earlier. Then after, we discussed the role of the nutrients and what is nutrition. Then after, we discussed the autotrophic nutrition and the autotrophic nutrition hold autotrophs, and animal and other organisms or plants have heterotrophs. Why? Because they are depend upon autotrophs. That is why animals are heterotrophs. That would be discussed. Then we discussed the process of photosynthesis, which occurs in the leaves. In leaves, there are pores, which known as stomata, and water and mineral and are transported to the leaves by the vessels. That what we discussed. Then after, we discussed about the green pigment available in the leaves are called chlorophyll. And then after, we discussed the process of photosynthesis, which only occurs in the presence of sunlight. And we come to know that sun is the ultimate source of energy for all living organisms. Then we discuss that there will not be any life in the absence of photosynthesis. Why? Because of photosynthesis only we get food and we get oxygen. That is essential for our life. Then after, we come to know with the help of carbon dioxide and water, with the help of sunlight and chlorophyll, carbohydrates and oxygen is the product. Then after, we come to know this figure and this figure also. Then after we discuss this activity, then we come to know that let it be the color of these plants is something different, like red, brown, but these are other pigment and those mask the green color. That is why green color we cannot see, but they have chlorophyll, and that is why the process of photosynthesis occur in these leaves also. Then after we come to know synthesis of plant food other than carbohydrates. Other than carbohydrates is what? Proteins and vitamins. That what we discussed. And protein is nitrogenous substance, and that is why nitrogen also required, and how they get nitrogen, that is also we discussed. Then other modes of nutrition in plants, and that what we discussed about amarvel, isn't it? Now this tree is host and amarvel is parasite. Then we discussed about this pitcher plant, and that is insectivorous plant. That word to be discussed in third part. By this time, this is the end of third part.
Thank you for joining us. Take care of yourselves, and we'll meet you in the next session. Thank you.